More than 6% against the euro this year. One way to protect yourself from a falling dollar is to invest in European assets. That will at least protect you against falls against the euro. Here with his best bets on playing Europe's recovery is Tom Lydon, editor of ETFTrends.com. Tom, good morning. Thanks for being with us.
Hi, Mark.
I'm assuming that you've got an ETF that will help.
Well, there are a couple. First, the iShares MSCI EMU index, which is about 270 stocks in the Eurozone. And again, as you mentioned, with the falling dollar, you're not only getting the appreciation that we've seen in these global markets, but also you're getting the dollar kicker as that translation from the euro back to our currency on a daily basis gives you that added appreciation. So just to put things in perspective, we've seen a 62% rise off the March 9th low in the S&P.
Right.
But some of these European markets have increased by 90% over that same period of time.
Yeah. They're also just currency ETFs, are they not?
Well, there are. There are many currency ETFs. And in fact, they're long and short dollar ETFs as well. So with ETFs, we've got more and more choices these days. You've got the diversification, the low cost, liquidity. And again, for the average investor out there, it's not now deemed to be aggressive to be investing overseas when two-thirds of the global market capitalization is outside of the U.S.
Tom, you had mentioned the currency ETFs, and in particular the long and the short ones. Are they all pretty much liquid, or are there some ETFs you can pinpoint and say, you know what, maybe investors should be a little bit cautious about these because the flows into them are just still a little bit low?
Not in the currency area. You're really seeing pretty liquid areas. And again, most of the money in there is cash. A small percentage is futures, just to be able to be in line with the current currencies. There's no concern regarding currency ETFs.
Okay. Thank you very much, Tom.
Thanks, folks.
Appreciate it.